Hi, I'm Jennifer Valverde, and today I will be demonstrating Digital Guardian for advanced threat protection. Digital Guardian detects attacks based on advanced behavioral analysis, making it faster and more accurate than traditional signature-based or fingerprinting methods. Our solution also provides deep data knowledge with visibility into all data events. Digital Guardian recognizes threatening behavior and uses real-time detection and containment to protect your sensitive data. On an endpoint with the Digital Guardian agent installed, I'm going to execute winrar.exe from the recycle bin via command line. I'm then going to launch WinRAR from the start menu as a behavioral comparison. Now let's go ahead and see the difference within the DGMC. Digital Guardian builds a story to determine the intent of the events, essentially answering, is this malicious behavior or not? Immediately, you can see the administrator is notified that the WinRAR application has been launched from the recycle bin and it used a command line process to do so. Another important fact to point out is that WinRAR in this case is not actually malware. However, it is a product capable of performing malicious activity, a true distinction between malware-only detection and behavior-based advanced threat protection. The entry vector being email, the fact it was launched from the recycle bin and using a command line may not each be alarming on their own, but once correlated together become more interesting. This is the reason for the correlated D1 IOC process unusual start, which is set to a high criticality. Digital Guardian tracks behaviors such as how is the process launched, variations of PowerShell, command line, and batch file launches, suspicious process launches, like launching from application data, recycle bin, recently created executables, or launching of executables that have just been downloaded, child and parent relationships, DLL downloads and injections, registry entries and modifications, just to name a few. At this point, a number of actions can be set into place, including which data a process is or is not allowed to perform actions against. Back on the endpoint, let's see what this looks like. On the right is the process launched from the start menu, and on the left is the process launched from the recycle bin. When I attempt to zip classified data, I receive a block. This is based on the fact that this particular process exhibited suspicious behavior before attempting to zip the sensitive data. You'll see here that the access is denied and Digital Guardian will block. If I attempt to zip the same data from the process launch from the start menu, I am allowed. Sensitive data can be blocked in both scenarios, but what I'm demonstrating here is the power of using behavioral context. In the DGMC, you'll notice that the administrator is alerted that a suspect process is attempting to modify classified data. This is set to the highest criticality. By working through this use case, you now have additional visibility into your environment that allows you to answer critical security questions, such as, is a process exhibiting malicious behavior? Does the combination of events indicate an attack? What is the goal of the specific events and actions? And what data may have been compromised? And what data is still secure? For more information, visit us at digitalguardian.com.